It's Nisha Jackson Show. How you doing?
Good.
And that's Nisha. And we're eating nuts and we're eating seeds. And you should join us. How you doing? Are nuts really that good? I mean, I like nuts a lot in like Snickers. Almond Joys, that's good too.
Okay, don't be a dingbat. We don't talk about that anymore because remember, you're healthy.
I am healthy. You know what's really weird?
You're healthy now.
Is I do not crave sugar anymore. I had some, like, I want to say maybe like the first time a couple of days ago, but just kind of out of the blue. But like, I don't crave it at all. And I used to every single day.
I know. And that's partly because you're not having it and your body is now, your nutrient levels, your vitamin levels have come up. And when you restore things like magnesium, B vitamins, vitamin D, everything starts working like a symphony. It's supposed to be in balance, right? So when your body's in balance, then you don't crave things that are actually bad for you as much.
Okay. Let me ask you. Okay. But before we get to that, I got to ask you a weird one.
Yeah.
Do you mind?
No, but go ahead.
Because this one's kind of gross.
I can handle anything you say. Okay. Well, most anything you say.
All right. So have you ever bought a Groupon?
No.
Do you know what a Groupon is?
Yes.
Okay. Yeah. You don't need to buy Groupons. I need to buy Groupons. Anyway, so I bought a Groupon for a girlfriend, and it was for a spa thing. And then she chickened out and just didn't want to go. Well, I'm looking at my phone watching this Groupon expire because they tick down. If you don't use them at a certain time, they expire.
Oh,
so I call them up because I'm, gosh, what's the word? Cheap. And I don't want to see, I don't want to just throw away, you know, it's like $70.
All right.
So I call them up and I say, so can I use it? Because it was for a woman's treatment.
Right.
And they said, well, okay. Sure, come on down. So I go down there and they say, well, we specialize in hydrocolonics. Really? Yeah.
Those are awesome.
Yeah. Are they because I did it because I don't want to waste that money.
But it's really good for you.
Is it?
Yeah. So colonics are when they, if you haven't had one, hydrocolonic is when you have a tube that goes in your rectum.
Lone River.
It goes in your anal canal, just a little ways up, and it basically irrigates your colon, your lower colon. And I hate to say this, but some people that have never had this that may have some health issues, especially fatigue, problems with digestion, many, many other issues related to the gut, or just generally how you feel, have the problem in the gut that there's so much stool caked to the sides of their colon that they're not absorbing the nutrients as well as they should. And I know that just sounds like almost impossible, like how could this happen, but yeah, it's true. And if you read about this and you listen to some of the stories of how much better people got when they started doing regular colonics, I don't know if you remember when I went to Rhythmia, the retreat in Costa Rica last summer, we did colonics every day. And it's a really good way to detox your system. And I recommend people have them regularly.
Okay. So I'm doing the right thing. So I've done two now. Mm-hmm. And you know, at one point the water gets all clear and you're thinking, okay, I'm done. And then she comes over and starts like jabbing on my gut. Right. And all of a sudden, whoa, and a volcano. And yeah.
Right. So it irrigates your colon, but then you release all the stool. So it goes back out the tube into a container that's, you know, self-contained. And it's a little nerve-wracking at first if you've never had one. It's a little scary. Like, are they going to blow up my colon? Like, am I going
to
blow up?
Because they want you to hold it too. They want, yes, you to hold it in, and that,
yeah,
it hurts for a while.
I don't know if I would use the word
uncomfortable.
I don't know
it's
if
uncomfortable.
I use the word hurt because, yeah, we want to encourage our audience to look at this because this is something that's good for you.
Okay.
But I wouldn't say hurt, but it is kind of like uncomfortable.
Yeah.
But I think it's a little nerve-wracking.
And I would agree with that. I would not say hurt. Uncomfortable is,
yes,
a better word.
Yeah. So I think that that's a really good lead into this subject today.
And one more thing. And then they topped it off with a coffee. They put coffee in there.
Yeah, coffee enema.
And that's good too?
I've actually not ever done that, but that is...
But that's, the coffee addict has never done the coffee one, I would think. They
why,
just
like, why do we eat coffee in my rectum when I can drink coffee and love it? I don't need any more coffee. No, no, it is. It can be very good for cleansing also.
Okay, so I did okay. So you would suggest people do that. That's not something at nishajackson.com, but it is something that people should maybe do.
No, just make sure you go to a certified one that's been doing it for a while and is very knowledgeable. So make sure you research that really well before you go, but it can be very important for detoxification and also for good colon health.
And that would help with nutrition, right?
Yes.
So
absorbing the nutrients in your colon, yes.
Okay, let's talk about a better nutrition and some things that we can eat. We're eating these nuts. We've got walnuts and almonds.
Yeah.
This is called pistachios. Pistachios are supposed to be really good for you. Yeah.
Yes. So, you know, we talk about nuts a lot and why nuts are really important, but one thing we don't talk very much about is seeds. Like, what kind of seeds are available, and why would we want to eat more seeds? Why would we want more seeds in our diet? And I just think it's so important to have these things at your desk and have them at work. Because so many times, I talk a lot about hitting the wall in the afternoon or eating, you know, when you're tired, you go for bad foods and they don't work well for you because they end up making you more tired. So having things like nuts and seeds sitting around like on bowls on your counter in your kitchen, at your home for your kids or you to eat, and also at work, it's so much better to feed yourself these kinds of things because they are filled with nutrients, amino acids, and wonderful things for your entire body, and they make a difference in opening up your brain, especially in the afternoon.
So much better than a bowl of Hershey's Kisses or something.
Yes, exactly. Although there is a benefit in having 1 ounce of dark chocolate about 3 o'clock in the afternoon because it raises a brain chemical called dopamine, and dopamine is kind of the get it done kind of brain chemical. When dopamine goes up, you're able to kind of fire up your engine and kind of plow through the rest of the day. So 1 ounce of dark chocolate's not a bad idea, but I would really like you to start feasting on more seeds. So I want to go through some seed options and what kind of benefits there are for seeds. First one I want to talk about is chia seeds.
Chia. Are those the ones you put on your hair and it grows? And like, you know,
No. These are tiny seeds that have 10 grams of fiber in just 2 tablespoons of chia seeds. Huh. And fiber's really good, Rusty, because if we would get more fiber in our diet, we wouldn't be hungry so much because it's very good for our gut. It's not only good for digestion, but it's really good for providing a sensation of fullness so that we can kind of control how much we're eating during the day. It's filled with amino acids, antioxidants, minerals, and it's wonderful to take those little chia seeds. You could spread them on cereal. You can spread them on the food that you've prepared for dinner, if you're preparing food for dinner. Not everybody does that. Or you can just eat them. Another thing that I really like from a seed standpoint, and I try to cook wild rice a lot. Wild rice is actually a seed, not a rice. And the thing that I love about wild rice is that it's not only really good for you because it provides a sensation of fullness, but it has 30 times more antioxidants than white rice. So maybe next time you go to the grocery store, you can think about not buying white rice as your small starch that you're going to have on your plate for dinner or lunch, but maybe cooking wild rice instead, which is a seed, and it's really good. It's also filled with magnesium, which is excellent for cardiovascular health, and zinc and B6.
And that is better than fried rice.
Yes.
Just double check it.
Better than fried rice. Okay. But good question, Rusty. Thank you. You have such good questions.
I'm glad I'm here to help.
Pumpkin seeds are filled with iron. It's 16% of your daily requirement of iron. So if you've been told that you're iron deficient, which so many people are, and one of the things I actually forgot to mention, Rusty, is that when you have too much yeast in your gut, your gut cannot absorb iron, and so you will often be tired because you're iron deficient. So I just wanted to put that little plug in there that if you have too much yeast in your gut, you're going to be iron deficient. But you could have pumpkin seeds, and pumpkin seeds are a real rich source of iron, 16% of your daily requirement, also rich in zinc. And zinc is excellent for your immune system. You've probably heard of like zinc lozenges when you get sick. Mm-hmm. So pumpkin seeds are really rich in zinc and excellent to put on things, not just at Halloween, but other times of the year. Cooking with them is really good, and also on salads. Pomegranate seeds.
Yes.
Those are like considered the little red jewels.
My kids love those.
Really?
Love them.
They're so good for you. I mean, here's the deal. If you want better skin, you want to age better, you want to get sick less.
That's good.
You want your gut to work better, you want to have less cravings, you want to sleep better at night. You got to give your body what it needs. And I love pomegranates because pomegranates are 40% of your daily needs of vitamin C. Oh. And vitamin C is really, really, really important for your immune system. Because I think vitamin C is one of those things, if I got stuck on an island and I didn't have access to any other supplement, I might be vitamin C, loads of vitamin C I'd want to get stuck with.
Let me ask you this. Now, we've talked about orange juice being bad, even though it talks about vitamin C. Right. I've seen pomegranate juice. Is that better or is that the same category?
So, yeah, I'm glad you said that. So, pomegranate juice, I think, you know, in small amounts is okay. But again, the seeds are better because we get the fiber. We get it in its most pure form. And so just think about all the things that we take and then we do something with that's really so much better in its most pure form. So I'd rather you just have the pomegranates. Also, one thing to take into consideration is, especially with oranges and juices, is how many oranges it takes to get orange juice. It's just a lot of extra sugar that you don't need. And I'd really like for you to have the fiber. Anyways, pomegranates are wonderful. They are filled with healthy antioxidants in addition to vitamin C. And they're great for your immune system and really, really, really good for your skin. They make your skin look good.
Okay.
All right. So quinoa is also an excellent food to have in your diet. So one thing I want you to just try to think about doing, instead of having a lot of starch at dinner, think about having seeds throughout the day, and then maybe at dinner time, limit your starch. You want your plate to be filled with vegetables, having a protein about the size of a deck of cards, and then you want your starch to be about the size, if you have a starch at all. I actually try not to have starch at dinner time, but if you have starch, just have your starch be a little tiny, almost like a condiment on your plate.
Okay. Now, is quinoa considered a starch?
Yes. A quinoa is a starch, but the great thing about it, it's very high in protein. And whenever you have a starch that's high in fiber and high in protein, it slows the release of sugar. That's why if you're going to have a carbohydrate, you want to have carbohydrates that are high in fiber because they don't turn to sugar immediately upon entering your mouth, which is kind of the whole idea with the whole weight gain, blood sugar instability, high insulin, all that stuff. You don't want to be storing fat at a higher rate, so you want your carbohydrates to be as high in fiber as possible.
Okay, now I've heard, you know, we talked about rice a little while ago and white rice, and I've heard that that's kind of a bad one, but I've heard that it's similar to quinoa. Is quinoa better than like white rice, for example?
Yes, because quinoa has a very high amount of protein in it, which is really excellent. One cup of quinoa has 8 grams of protein, which is awesome. And like I said, it's filled with amino acids. It has that really nice nutty flavor. I think it tastes delicious, but you don't need a lot of it. I would say a cup or less is what you should have. I mean, some people will have just a half a cup, but it's just kind of nice to have that on your plate. You can mix it in with salads and it's delicious.
Okay.
All right. So those are some of the flax seeds is another one. I should maybe give some little talk about hormones and flax seeds, because flax seeds are excellent in balancing women's hormones. And so adding flax seeds to your diet not only increases the omega-3s in your diet, which are the good fats in the diet, but they're excellent for hormone balance. So if you're suffering from PMS, you're suffering from menopausal symptoms, adding more flaxseed to your diet actually can help reduce symptoms, hormone symptoms. And you can put them in muffins. Well, actually, I shouldn't say muffins, because we don't want you to eat muffins unless they're protein-based muffins. Okay. But there's actually some really good muffins you can make that are not flour-based.
All right, let me ask you a question, Muffin. And that is, I'm allergic to fish oil. And was told I had to have fish oil, and was told, since I'm allergic to it, to do flaxseed oil.
Yes.
Is that something, would you agree with that?
Yes. Yeah. Or krill oil. There's other types of oils you can have, but absolutely.
I've heard good things about flaxseed oil.
Yes. Yeah, absolutely. I mean, flaxseed's got some, you know, it's funny. It's like even good stuff gets bad rap sometime. And there's been some concern that flaxseed at certain times, you know, there's certain studies that have come out and said maybe flaxseed, but I just think you really need to keep things in moderation. flax seeds are not the only seeds you should have. Flaxseed oil is not the only oil you should have. So just keeping a good variety in your diet and not ODing on the next thing that you hear is great. And that's the thing we do a lot. Don't you find that we do that a lot? We hear that something's good, so we just go all in. Juicing's good, so then that's all we do is juicing. So just keep that in mind, that your body is meant to have a variety, and we're not meant to have the same types of food all the time, because that's how we develop sensitivities or allergic reactions to certain types of food, is that we just eat them all the time. Even good food you can develop a sensitivity to. So flax seeds are really good to cook with and to eat, and flaxseed oil is excellent.
Okay. All right. And you know another thing that is excellent?
What?
Pickup sticks.
Pickup sticks are excellent.
Pickup sticks.
In fact, having pickup sticks in your water bottle and having a bowl of seeds to munch on in the afternoon is not only wonderful for your entire health, but it will keep you eating the right things, and it will keep your brain opened up and processing till you get all the way through your day instead of burning out in the afternoon.
Well, what is a pickup stick, Nisha? What are we talking about? I don't know.
Okay, pickup stick is a little, it looks like this. This one's not branded, but it looks like this. It goes in your water bottle, and you shake up your water bottle and you drink it. And you've already drank your pickup sticks, and it is filled with antioxidants, B vitamins. It has a high dose of quercetin in it, which is an antioxidant, a really potent antioxidant. It has green tea for energy, so it's more of a natural energy, and it doesn't make you nervous, jittery, wound up. But it's excellent for opening up your brain. It has ginkgo and ginseng in it. So it's not only good for you, but it increases your energy, improves your recovery after workouts, and it's excellent for turning your brain back on when you start getting fuzzy. And that can happen any time of day. You can wake up feeling fuzzy.
You know what would make this almost a perfect item?
What's that?
If you had like a celebrity endorser
right.
in this. Yeah.
That's right. Oh, that's right. I do have one.
Let's play the commercial.
For as long as I can remember, I struggled with mental clarity and just kind of a lack of focus. You know, I'm always on go, and I can feel myself running throughout the day. And towards the end, I kind of just burn out. And that's when I kind of made it a priority after last season to figure out a way to help with, you know, lack of sleep, overall energy, you know, everything along those lines. And that's when I started working with Nisha.
Today, the most common thing that we see in the medical office is people are exhausted. Their nervous systems are worn out, and they don't really know what to do about it. So when I started working with Odell, and he told me about his symptoms of muscle pain and focus and a little bit of brain fog, I knew right away that this was a common problem and that we needed to fix it.
We worked on a supplement and a vitamin that is specifically tailored to me, that helped me with my focus, also helped me get great sleep, and that's kind of how it all started.
X is the variable that you didn't really know you needed, but it's probably the thing that you need the most. And people today that are suffering from common problems like exhaustion and brain fog and poor recovery, they don't know what to take. They have no idea what ingredient they actually need. But what they really need is they need a combination of ingredients, the right dose of ingredients, and responsible ingredients put together for specific problems that will help them get over their symptoms quickly.
When we started Brand X, my hope was to create vitamins and supplements that were different from anything else in the market. I wanted something that gave me real results, more sustained energy, mental clarity, and quicker recovery. Without putting toxins and sugar into my body, I'm excited for you to try these and hope Brand X can help you as much as it's helped me on a daily basis.
How cool is that? You got the, again, what's his name?
Odell. Odell Beckham Jr. OBJ.
OBJ.
OBJ or O. He's O.
He's O. And it's he's awesome.
X.
Yeah. Yeah. I can do that too. So it's very cool. And you really did help design this with him in mind, because he's one of your favorite football players. You heard he was kind of having a tough time. And so you came up with this so that he would be better, stronger, faster at his job.
And focused. Focused. Because obviously, if you're playing at that level, I mean, all of us need focus, right? But when you're playing at that level, you need to be firing. Your brain needs to be on, and you need to be focusing. And probably getting hit in the head as much as football players do, it's probably kind of hard on the focus, don't you think? So I think he's going to keep using these sticks.
Let's see. Do you have any idea of how I would get them if I wanted to order some?
Actually, I do. You just go to takebrandx.com.
Takebrandx.
That's right.
Takebrandx.com.
And have nuts them. And seeds. Nuts and seeds.
Have them with your nuts and seeds.
And nuts and seeds.
All right. Go to NishaJackson.com to find out more about every topic. We're kind of creating quite a library of health solutions for you. And by going to NishaJackson.com, you'll be able to go back and see all of them. And we have transcripts of a lot of the shows. You can go back and get some of those. So please go to NishaJackson.com. Before you go there, though, please hit the subscribe button, whether you're watching on YouTube or Facebook. Share it out. Also, if you're listening on Apple Podcasts, Google Podcasts, watching on Roku, Apple TV, Fire TV, wherever you are, watch it, share it, let people know, because really, this is one of the best shows I've ever seen. It's not because of me, I guarantee you that. It's because of her. And just the kind of information that she's giving really can change lives. So please go to NishaJackson.com, subscribe, tell your friends, and we sure appreciate you. We'll see you next time. I'm Rusty Humphries. That's Nisha Jackson, Dr. Nisha Jackson, and this is the Dr. Nisha Jackson Show.